Good morning, my dear friends. Good morning. Good morning, everyone. Good morning, my dear friends. Good morning, Vaibhav, Sagar, Shubham, everyone. Good morning. फटाफट आ जाइए सारे बच्चे. Good morning, my dear friends. So where were we? कहाँ पे पहुँचे थे हम लोग? थोड़ा सा डिस्कशन करते हैं फटाफट, उसके बाद आगे बढ़ते हैं. गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन. ओके यस यस एवरीवन इज हियर माय डियर फ्रेंड्स. लेट एवरीवन ज्वाइन. Let everyone join. Okay, so where were we? We have yesterday completed irrigation requirements, irrigation efficiencies. We have solved some questions also. Okay, today we will be starting with water logging. Okay, and we will be dealing what things are important, what things are not. So myself Chetan Sir, my best grade rank is already 95. I am an expert in GATE, ESE, SSC, JEE and various other exams. I have pursued my master's from IIT Roorkee in structural engineering. My best grade score is 902 and my teaching experience in GATE industry is more than 3 years. You can use my code CS10 to get 10% off on all plus subscription. Okay. What are the advantages of plus subscription? Batches run in English and Hindi both. There are doubt reading sessions after every 4th class. There are weekly assessments also. Then there is rank improvement batch in order to enhance your rank. For repeaters it is mainly, okay, for students who have passed out and who have basic knowledge of the subject. Then there are crash courses. Then there are live classes on each topic. Yes, okay. So so till now what all we have covered, we have studied all the types of irrigation, we have studied all the methods of irrigation. Okay, then we have studied quality of irrigation water, we have studied everything. Then we have covered the basic formulas, okay, the depth of water. Then we understood the soil moisture relationship. Then we understood the depth of water, of available water. Then we understood depth of relatable moisture. Okay, we understood the graph, everything was there. Okay, we solved one example. You all know how to calculate frequency, how to calculate number of times your farmer has to irrigate the land. Then we understood the relationship between crop growth and water content. Then crop seasons were there, okay, and yesterday we recalled that in kharif season rice was your major crop, okay, rice was your major crop which is grown in monsoon season. And then in rabi season your wheat is there, then in your rabi season wheat is there, okay. Kharif crop requires 2 to 3 more times water than rabi crops. Then we solved one question, we studied duty delta, and I told you in duty delta all the definitions, what was core period, what was base period, what was crop period, what was core watering, what was core depth, what was pell irrigation. Okay, you all remember all these things? Yes, okay, you all remember all these things. So you can see this is your base period, first and last watering, time gap, and the time for which your crop remains there, it is your crop period. Then relationship was there. You have to remember this formula. This was in a meter, this was in your centimeter. So we understood the factors also. Then we studied duty at various places. Then we understood all the important terms, GCA, CCA, everything was there. Out of CCA, the area which is cultivated is known as cultivable cultivated area. And the area which is remaining, which you are not sowing, is your uncultivated. Okay. Then we understood intensity of irrigation, then crop ratio was there, then time factor, capacity factor, you all know. Okay, we solved examples, we solved all these definitions with example, then overlap allowance was there. You all know that canal does not run full for entire time period, okay. So The ratio of number of days is your time factor, and the ratio of capacity. Every time your canal will not flow full, okay? So the ratio of capacity is your capacity factor. Then overlap allowance, outlet factor, humidity, everything was there, okay? You all remember these. Then from yesterday class, okay, from yesterday we solved a question on irrigation efficiency. So what we understood, water conveyance efficiency, you all remember, application efficiency, you all remember, use, you all remember, okay? The water which you apply in field and the amount of water which is actually stored in root zone is your nothing but water application efficiency. And the water applied in field, out of that only some amount of water is used beneficially. That is your water use efficiency. And where my water is used, sir? Sir, water is used by crop, consumptive requirement, then leaching requirement, then pre-sowing requirement, and its water requirement. In today's chapter of water logging, okay? In today's chapter of water logging, you will understand leaching requirement. What is leaching and why water is required for it? You will understand today. Then water storage efficiency is there. Suppose 50 mm water is required. 50 mm water is required. You have to provide more water. You have to provide more water in order to store 50 because of losses. Then water distribution efficiency was there. 1 - y/d. Okay, simply. Then we solved one question. Questions were there. Okay. Then irrigation requirement was there. This can be asked in exam. So there was your consumptive irrigation requirement. What was your consumptive irrigation requirement? The water required by your plant. The water required by your plant is known as your irrigation requirement. Okay. And that is nothing but evapotranspiration needs, total consumptive requirement needs minus your rainfall. Okay. Rainfall is already provided. Na? So that you don't have to provide with irrigation. Okay. Then net was total water requirement was, then first one was your consumptive irrigation, then was your leaching, then pre-sowing, then nursery. Okay. So this was a total water requirement in your field. Okay. Then your field, the water which you have to apply to field should be more than NIR. Okay. Why? Because some water was lost in runoff and deep percolation. Okay. So water application efficiency should be higher. And then was your gross irrigation. And then was my gross irrigation, the water which has to start from river has to be even more, because meanwhile conveying this water, because in the meanwhile when the water is being conveyed, losses will happen, sir. And what these losses are called? These losses are called, my dear sir, conveyance loss. These losses are called conveyance loss. Okay, my dear friend? Yes. So out of these four irrigation requirements, obviously you all know CIR is least, and rest NIR, FIR, GIR even higher. Okay, you all remember these things. Then we solved many questions. Today we will take up one more question. Till then, more friends will join us. Okay, so I am giving you one more question. Start solving, because remember one thing, that in exam questions will be asked. Okay, and you have to stay prepared for all type of questions which are coming there. So let's take one more question, so that you are more clear with the concepts. Okay, so that you are more clear with the concepts. So here it is. Okay, so this is your question. Start solving, take out your calculator. We have to solve questions. When you will apply your brain, you will also get up, you will also woke up. I know it is hard to get up early in the morning. Okay, so there is an agricultural land. So there is an agricultural land, my dear friend. There is agricultural land. Okay. Of 437 hectare. Which is irrigated by, which is being grown by a certain crop. Okay, only one crop is grown there. The base period of the crop is 90 days, and total depth of water required by crop is, and total depth of water required is 105 cm, my dear friends. 105 cm. Okay, so if a rainfall of this is your question of GATE. If a rainfall of 15 centimeter occurs during this period, during this base period, then find the duty of irrigation water. Very simple thing. What options are given here? Option A is 437 hectare per cubic. Option B given, it's given as 486 hectare per cubic. Then option C is given as 741 hectare per cubic. Then option D is given as 864 hectare per cubic, my dear friends. And this question, my dear friends, has been asked in GATE 2008. Start solving. I am giving you 1 minute, then we will move ahead. Okay, 1 minute is being given to you all. It is very simple. You all know the formula of duty. We can directly apply formula, or you can simply use your logic. Shubham is asking, sir, irrigation requirement arrangement is on what basis and water required of application? Water required or application point of view? So it is based on water requirement, okay? It is based on water requirement. And Sushma is asking that, can you explain the methods to find conductivity of the water? That part, Sushma, I cover in hydrology. How to find consumptive use, okay? Let me tell you, Sushma Kumatrati, I am going to tell you how to find consumptive use of water. Let me tell you, you can find consumptive use of water with the help of some equations, some empirical equations, such as Penman equation is there, Pliny-Crittle equations are there, okay? Many empirical formula are there. Many scientists have performed many experiments, okay? Many experiments have been experimented out, and they have calculated the formula which almost give the similar results with very least amount of error. So Penman equation is very famous, and this I cover in hydrology, because in hydrology there is one topic, evapotranspiration, and you all know evapotranspiration is nothing but consumptive use. The water which your crop and field consumes together is your evapotranspiration. And that is similar to consumptive use. So evapotranspiration is a loss of rainfall, and I covered that topic in hydrology. Okay. So Penman equation is there, and more equations are there. Okay. Yes. So no problem. Okay. Good. So it is very simple. You all know what is duty. You all know, my dear friend, what is duty. Duty is simply area upon discharge. Discharge, you all know, this is it. Okay, now what is the area given in question? Area, my dear sir, is given as 430 hectare, but how will I find the discharge? Listen, first, or you can simply do it by, you know how. There is no need to write discharge as volume upon time. This you also can do. Time is also given to you as how much? 90 days, okay? And rainfall requirement is also there. Depth is also there. You can directly use this formula, okay? This formula will directly give you the answer, because we have already solved from basics, okay? You can use this formula. You know duty is equal to 8.64 P by delta, okay, because there is no need to solve this formula, again. Okay, you need to find UT. Then this is your 8.64. Base period is simply given as 90 days. You will keep 90 here. Delta we have to find out. Acha, how much water we have to provide by irrigation? How much water we have to provide with the help of irrigation? You know, my crop requires 105 cm. And rainfall, with the help of rainfall, it has been supplied with 15 cm. So how much water more is required now? 90 cm. Okay. So in case of delta, we will put 0.9, not 90, because in meter it is coming out to be 0.9. When you will solve this, my dear friend, you are absolutely getting correct. 864 hectare per cubic. Okay. There is no problem. Okay, this is your answer. D will be your option. And I hope you all remember this formula. Today only I have shown you this formula. And since 8.64 is here, you have to keep in mind here. Okay, remember this formula. And if you would have used 864, then your delta was in centimeter. So you can use this also. Okay. Yes. So now let's move on to our next topic, which is my water logging. As you have all seen in the thumbnail. No problem. You can use the formula which is in centimeter. I already told you. Okay, so now let's start the topic, water formula. What is water logging? How it is caused? How it can be controlled? What are the ill effects of it? Okay, kya kya problem aati hai? We already deal with everything. Okay, so now let's put on the heading. Okay. Can you tell me what is water logging? Can you tell me, my dear friends? And can you tell me why it is caused? Does anyone have any idea what is water logging and how it is caused? So we will start dealing with it. Can anyone of my friend here tell me what is water logging? Sir, it is very simple. It is nothing. No rocket science is there as such. Okay. So listen, my dears. It is simply a phenomenon. Listen, my field. You all know that agricultural field is there. You all know. But sometimes what happened due to excessive rain or any condition, sometimes water seeps from canal. Due to any condition, your field is flooded with water. Suppose there were many crops, and your water has flooded here. How it can happen? Heavy rains can be there. Okay, groundwater comes up. Okay, this can be your reason. There are no proper drainage. Okay, your farmer has gone mad, and he's providing water. He's keep on providing water. Okay. So yes, very good. Over irrigation is a problem. Intensity of irrigation is very high. So many things are there. I will make notes. I will write down each and every point in full detail. So keep focusing. So now what happens? You now understood, sir. You are telling me the causes, that this is why water logging is there. But what are the harmful effects? Like Sushma is telling that air voids are occupied by water, and which kills my useful bacteria. Absolutely correct. This is one of the disadvantages. First, let me write down the basic definition. I will write, it is a phenomenon in which productivity of land gets affected. In which productivity of land. Okay, your land is not suitable. Your land is not suitable now to grow crops. It will severely affect, water logging phenomena will severely affect the productivity of your land, and now crops will grow in less amount. Okay, your crops will not be able to grow properly. That's why it is a phenomenon in which productivity of land gets affected, in which productivity of land is highly affected, gets affected. Okay, my dear friend, due to high groundwater table, due to high groundwater table. And how come groundwater table has gone high? There are many reasons behind it. We will deal each and every reason. Don't worry. Affected due to high groundwater table. Due to high groundwater table. Leading to flooding of root zone. Which leads to flooding of root zone. Which leads to flooding of root zone. Now listen very carefully, my friends. Now listen very carefully. This is your land. This is your land. This is your plant. Okay, this is your plant. These are the roots of your plant. Okay, these are the roots of your plant. This is your roots. Okay, these are leaves. Roots are there. Now, what happens? Listen very carefully. Now, water is there. Somewhere here. Water table is somewhere here. Okay. Water table is somewhere here. Okay, no problem, sir. Now what happens? Now due to any of the causes, water table starts coming up. First, you understand these roots which are present in soil. Okay, in soil you all know voids are there. And in voids, two things can be there. First is your air. And second is your water, which you have provided from the field. Some water is also there, which is retained there against gravity. I already told you about field capacity. The water which is retained in the pores is known as capillary water. Okay. And some water which remains in the pores is your capillary water. And it is there. Okay. So, why are you telling this, sir? I am telling you this. Like, because your plant, your crop requires both. Your crop requires both things. Yes, very good. Your air is also required, your capillary water is also required. So, I will write down that this capillary water, okay, is required for growth of my plant, required for crop growth. Obviously, it will require water, like you all require water. And this air, why this air is necessary? Because in these voids, air and water, both things are there, okay, you can see here. Yes. So, air is required because this air is used by your bacteria. You must have read about leguminous plant. What are your leguminous plant, my dear sir? Leguminous plants are nothing which, these are plants which can fix nitrogen. Okay. And how come they fix nitrogen? With the help of a bacteria known as rhizobium bacteria. Okay. These rhizobium bacteria take air. Okay. These are aerobic bacteria. These take air and help plant in growth. Okay. These rhizobium bacteria, with the help of air, they fix nitrogen. They fix nitrogen in the form of root nodules. Okay, in root, small nodules happen when they fix. Okay, these nodules are filled with nitrogen, and this nitrogen is acting as a fertilizer, is acting as a catalyst for the growth of my plant. Okay, so now for the survival of this bacteria, my dear friends, or any useful bacteria, air has to be there, because from air it will take the nitrogen. Nitrogen comes only from air. Okay. It requires air. Free circulation of air has to be there. Okay. That's why you must have seen that what happens sometimes your what farmer plows the field. Okay, what he do, he plows the field so that after mixing there is too much of circulation of air and your bacteria is able to fix nitrogen from air. So I will say that this air is required by my bacteria. Okay, this air is required by bacteria, which indirectly helps in my plant growth. Okay, which indirectly helps, air is required by bacteria, which is indirectly affecting growth of plant. Okay, so this is the thing. Now what happens when your water is flooded, when your field is flooded, my dear friend, now let me write down. Acha, now listen very carefully. Now listen what happens. So you can see this diagram. What happens when your field is flooded with water? Now what will happen? Where some heavy rainfall is there, flood is there. Think of any reason due to which your water can be flooded. Now what will happen? Your this groundwater table will rise. Okay, listen very carefully. This groundwater table will rise, and when groundwater table will rise, you all know this. These voids which are earlier filled with air. Okay, that air will be gone, and your voids will be saturated. Here water will be filled, and all the voids, my dear friends, will be filled with water, and there will be no air. And when there will be no air, what will happen, my dear friend? When there will be no air, your bacteria will die, and when your bacteria will die, there will be problem for your roots. Okay, and listen very carefully. Every living being on this planet needs everything. Okay, they need water also, they need air also, they need nutrients also. Okay, they need three things. Your plant requires three things. First, it requires air, then it requires, my dear sir, it requires water, and then it requires all the nutrients. Okay, the nutrients which helps in building the cells of my plant. You know that farmer applies fertilizer in the form of nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium. You must have heard NPK. Okay, nutrients are your nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium. In India, the fertilizer used are this only. In India, these fertilizers are only used. Okay, which are used nutrients and helps in fast growth of your plant. Now what happens, sir? What happens? Listen very carefully. Okay, so listen here. So what happens? Once your water table starts rising. Now listen, what is the concept behind water logging? Listen. So once your water reaches, when your water table is higher, when your groundwater table has come higher, then what will happen? You all know in soil capillary rise is there. This water will rise automatically due to capillary effect. You must have heard. Kindly comment, you must have heard about capillary rise. Okay, you all know this is your water table level. Okay, this is the water table level, but still some water rises under capillary effect. In the small capillaries, some water is rising up due to small pores, due to surface tension. You all know the phenomena of capillary rise. Okay, so this water rises here, and this layer is known as capillary zone. Okay, this level is known as capillary zone. If anyhow your root and this capillary zone, this root and capillary zone comes in contact, yes, then what happens? Wait, let me write down. This is your capillary zone. This is your capillary water which rises automatically above your groundwater level. Okay, which rises above your groundwater level. Then what will happen? Your roots will start taking this water. Why, sir? Why it happens? You all have to understand, my dear, that daily, in entire day, when your sunrise is there, okay, when your sun is there, when your daylights are daylight is there, in entire day you all know sun is there. Okay, what sun will do? Sun will create vacuum inside your plant. Why? Because you know transpiration occurs. You know transpiration occur. Water will go out. Water will go out. And since water goes out, here inside plant vacuum is there. Here in plant vacuum is there. Vacuum occurs. Okay. So what happens? What happens? That water is sucked. Okay. Since vacuum is there, it will try to go out. Water is sucked from capillary zone. And from this capillary zone, my dear friends, and from this capillary zone, water will start rushing through the roots. Water will start rushing through the roots and move in the roots, and then it will go through the phylum. Okay, then it will go through xylem. Okay, the fiber cells of your plant. Then it will go through fiber cells of your plant, and it will leave the and it will leave through leaves. It will leave through leaves in the form of transpiration. Okay, you must have. You all know that when you suck any water or you any liquid with the help of a straw, you must have drunk fruity. You must have taken any liquid in the form of a straw. What you do, you dip the straw and suck it. Okay, you suck it, and what happens? That from below rushes. Why it rushes? Because when you suck the straw from which you drink any liquid, what happens? Vacuum is created, and in similar fashion, this is your straw. This is acting as a liquid which you are drinking. This capillary water below is acting as a liquid which you are drinking. This is your straw, and here the sun is acting as your mouth. Okay, this sun is trying to suck all the water outside because of the intense heat. Your plant has to transpire too much of water. Okay, from the leaves through the stomatal openings. You all know there are many stomatal openings. Okay, stomata is there. Okay, so now what will happen if this cycle continues? My dear friend, what will happen if this cycle will continue, that water is keep going out, what will happen? Okay, this starts and siphon action is set up. Wait, let me show it here. Then your water is going on coming out. Okay, it comes out, and all the water is flooded here. Why? Because the rate at which water is coming out is much higher than it is being transpired. Okay, now you can see a reaction is set up, a continuity is set up, and all the water will come out very fast, and you will see that your entire field is flooded with water, and this is a very big problem. Why it is a big problem, sir? Because water will immediately rise from ground and reach your field. A setup is there, a siphon action is set up, and your field is flooded. Earlier you can see air was there, but after this suction process is set up, entire water from groundwater comes out. Sir, now what is the problem? Now when this groundwater reaches your surface with the help of capillary action, okay, it brings salt. Listen very carefully, this is the problem, and this my farmer has to remove the problem and treat the problem. Okay, then how will you deal with it? Your groundwater contains soluble salts. Listen very carefully, your groundwater contains soluble salts. Let me explain this concept first. It is very simple. You all must be familiar with this. Suppose this is your land. This is your roots. I am drawing big root, little big root. Okay. This is your root. Okay. And this is your plant. Now, suppose this land is flooded with water. Suppose somehow groundwater has reached your, somehow groundwater has reached the surface, entire field is flooded with water, okay, entire field is flooded. Now what will happen? This is a road. Listen very carefully. Let me draw here. This is a road, okay. And since your field is flooded with water, I am writing it here. Your root is completely submerged in water. Acha, the water which is inside your root, okay, there is water which is inside root also. I will say it as root water. Water which is already present. Obviously, you all know that your body is also made up of water. Okay, your body is also made of water. So obviously, your plant body, your plant root is also made of water. And the water which is outside, I will call it as pore water. Okay. Yes, sir. No problem. This is simple. Now, what happens? What problem is there? Sir, tell me the problem. You all know that if this pore water has high concentration of salt, it contains high concentration of salt, and your root water have salt in less quantity because less nutrients are there. What is your salt? Nothing. It is your sodium, calcium, magnesium, potassium. All these things are your mineral contents, and this will be counted in salts. You all know many examples: Na2SO4, okay, NaCl, Na2CO3. These three are the very common salts which are found there. Okay, these three, my dear friend, these three are very common salts which are found in field, which are very common, commonly found in fields. Okay, so now what happens? Now you all know, suppose this is your semi-permeable membrane. Now suppose this line, this border is your semi-permeable membrane. Okay, it means it only permits something. It only permits something to pass and some things are stopped. But that's a semi-term is used here. Okay. And you know, behind this semi-permeable membrane, this semi-permeable membrane is similar to your root wall. Okay. Can you see the skin of the root? This root skin is similar to semi-permeable membrane, and behind this membrane is your root water. Okay, inside of root, and outside this root wall, pore water is there. What is there? Pore water is there. Okay, no problem. Now what will happen? Since my dear sir, outside root salt concentration is high. And how come salt concentration high? Because this groundwater has many soluble salts in it. Let me write down a note here. Groundwater has high concentration of salt water. Has high concentration of soluble salts in it. Already many salts are dissolved in your groundwater. Are you getting my point? Many salts are already dissolved in your groundwater. And on the root side, since water, in the root water, salt is less. And okay, you can see, so now listen very carefully. When you will talk of concentration, when it will come to concentration, if you can say that out of 100%, 6% is your salt, and out of 100%, 3% is your salt, then this 3% can be your root water, and this 6% can be your outside water, which is outside root. Okay. And here salt is more and water is less relatively. Here you will say 6% salt is there, and when you will minus it, 94% water is there. And here in this example, you will say 3% salt is there, and when you minus it out, okay, when you subtract it, you will say 97% water is there. Okay, you all can relate it. So I can say, sir, on this side, salt is more and water is less relatively. Okay, both accounts for 100%, both comes out at 100%, and on this side and inside root. Inside root water is high relatively, okay, not the total quantity of water I am talking of. I am talking it in concentration, okay, and salt is less. Now what happens since this semi-permeable membrane allows water to pass? You all know the nature rules. The rule of nature is flow occurs from high level to low level. This is a rule. Okay, electrons flows from higher potential to lower potential. Anything flows from higher gradient to lower gradient. Okay, now what will happen? Since water is less here and inside root water is high, your water will start flowing out. Okay, water will start coming out of your root. and this is a problem, because water is high here and water is less on outside side, so water will start flowing. A gradient is set up, okay? Say because of gradient is there, difference is, gradient means difference of concentration is there, okay? Because of difference in concentration, what will happen with this phenomena? Because of difference of concentration of water, my dear sir, because of difference of concentration of salt and water, my dear sir, a gradient is set up and water will start coming out of root. And when your water will start coming out of root, once your water will start coming out of root, what will happen? What will happen? Your plant will die because water is coming out. Water is coming out. Now, if you will go to the root cause, if you'll analyze deeply why water is coming out, why only water is coming out, you will say because of salt. You will say this has happened because of salt concentration. You will say this is happening. You will say this is happening because your groundwater, because your pore water is having high concentration of salt. You will say this. You will say, my dear friend, salt concentration is high in groundwater, okay, in pore water. Now, this is a very big problem. This is a very big problem, and this actually happens. And your farmer is worried. And your farmer is worried after water logging, okay? So whenever water logging will be there, you can relate salt concentration will be high, or you can say water concentration relatively will be low, and water will start coming out of roots. You must be wondering why salt is not going inside. Here salt is there. Salt is also high outside, na? So salt can go also from outside to inside. But since this membrane is semi-permeable in nature, it only allows water to pass through it. Since this membrane is semi-permeable, semi means it only permits something to pass and it stops something, okay? It also acts as barrier for something. So salts cannot go out. Salts are unable to go inside because these salt molecules are bigger than the openings of semi-permeable membrane. These salt molecules are bigger than the openings of and pores of your semi-permeable membrane. That is your root skin. So only water will come out. Okay, water will pass. Semi-permeable means, let me tell you, only water is allowed to pass, but salt is not allowed to pass. Okay, this means semi-permeable. It allows something. Okay, now I have understood, sir. Now I have understood that with the help of groundwater, let me write here. No place is left. Okay, now water can come out in any form with the help of cap reaction. I already told you, with the help of cap reaction, entire suction process will be set up and entire water will come out. This is the way. Or simply your water table can rise. When heavy water is there. Now, there is one next definition which is known as efflorescence. Listen, let me write down. There is one definition known as efflorescence. This can be asked. Okay. What is your efflorescence? Now, what happens? Now, you all know that whenever water logging will happen, no matter what, when water logging can happen in any way, now water logging has occurred, okay? Now your field is flooded with water. And obviously you all, my dear friends, know that when your field is flooded with water, there are soluble salts in it, okay? Soluble salts or concentration has increased, okay? Now what will happen? With passage of time, listen very carefully. This water which is already present, okay, which is already present near the surface or on the surface, water is here. With passage of time, this water will evaporate. You all know. Spread some water on your field and after a day, you will see all water has evaporated. And you will see that this water will start evaporating. And after evaporating, it will leave behind all the soluble salts which are already present. You all know, soluble salts will not go out. Soluble salts are not volatile, okay? Let me write down here. Soluble salts are not volatile and it will remain there. Soluble salts are not volatile. Okay, are not, only water will go. So I will say that after evaporation water will grow and salts will remain there. Salts remain on field, and when salts remain on field, white patches will occur. Okay, white patches will occur. It will come later, my dear friend, in Hindi. Okay, it will come later. Salts remain on field. What I am saying, water. Okay, water will evaporate. Water will go up. Water will go up, and salt will remain on the field. When salt remains there, white patches occurs. Arey, obviously you all know when salts will remain, white patches will occur on the field. Okay. This white patches on your field indicates that salts are there. Your land has gone. Your land has been spoiled. You will write here. You will write here. What is efflorescence? Formation of white patches. Formation of white patches after evaporation of after wait. After evaporation of locked water, water which was ponded there, water which was locked there, after evaporation of locked water is known as efflorescence. Okay, and why it occurs? Why it occurs, my dear friend? Listen, let me write down here. Because salts remain in the field, because salts remain behind. Okay, and water goes. Okay, and your water goes. Now let me arrange the salts. I told you these are the three salts, sodium sulfate, okay, chloride, sodium carbonate. Let me tell you which salt is most harmful and which salt is least harmful. Okay, this can be asked, so I am telling you. You all must remember these three, that in this, let me write down the order of severeness. If you talk the harmfulness of salts, let me write down. Soluble salts are harmful to your roots. Why? I told you today, soluble salts are harmful to roots. The salt which is most harmful out of these three is your sodium carbonate. It is sometimes also called as black alkali. Sodium carbonate. You all must have heard sodium carbonate Na2CO3. It is also present in washing soda. Then the second most harmful is your Na2SO4. And then the least harmful is your NaCl. Then your least harmful salt is NaCl. This is the order of severity. This is the order of severity or harmfulness, you can say. Okay, my dear friend. So now, you all know that salts are harmful. Why? Because root water is coming out. Sir, because of salt, root water comes out. And when my root water will come out, roots will shrink. And when roots will shrink, root will die. So my plant will also die. Okay. Roots are everything. Roots are the foundation of your plant. If roots die, everything will die. Okay. Yes, sir. I understood this. Now, sir, tell me three things. I want to know three things. What are the three things? Listen very carefully. You want to know what are the harmful effects of waterlogging? First, effects. Then you have to understand causes of waterlogging. Causes. Why waterlogging is occurring? Because in questions, many factors are asked. Like how waterlogging is occurring. Okay. Many points will be given. So you have to remember all those points. And after that, after the causes and harmful effects, I will tell you what my farmer do in order to control that water logging. That is very much important, because you are an engineer, and from engineer's point of view, you need to solve the problem. Okay, so three things you have to study now: ill effects, what are the harmful effects, then what causes your water logging, and after that, we have to study how water logging can be controlled. Okay, we have to study that. Okay, now let's start. First, let me write down all the harmful effects. One by one, I will write everything. Harmful effects or ill effects. Ill effects of water logging. You tell me what are the ill effects of water logging. I have made very clear the entire process for you all. First one is very simple. Can you tell me? Simply, air will be reduced. Ill aeration, I will say poor aeration. And what poor aeration will do? It will kill my bacteria. And suffocate root. Okay, it will kill bacteria which are useful. Okay, simply it will kill bacteria which are useful, and obviously then it will affect your plant growth. Your yield will be reduced. Earlier if 100 ton crop was there, now only 50 ton will be there when important bacteria are killed. Then what will happen, my dear friend? Sir, salinity will increase. Okay, salt concentration will increase. Now, salt concentration will increase. This is the biggest problem, my dear sir, because all the water of root will come out. Okay, I will write down, salinity will increase, and this is the problem. No one wants salinity. Okay, why it is a problem? Because root shrinks. And now you will ask, why root shrink? Because all the water come out. Okay, let me write down, water comes out of root under osmosis. Biggest problem. You know osmosis? The phenomena which I showed you here was osmosis. Let me show it again. See, this water is going out of root. Because of concentration gradient, because of the difference, water was going out, and this process is known as osmosis. This phenomenon is known as osmosis. Flow of water from high concentration to low concentration of it is known as osmosis. Simple. And this will make my root shrink and your plant will die. So salinity is increased. And alkalinity is also increased. See, salinity and alkalinity are almost one and the same thing. Suppose this is NaCl. This NaCl, which is a salt, which is increasing the salinity. This salt can be either acidic in nature, or basic in nature, or alkaline in nature. There are two natures of salt. Either your salt can be acidic or it can be alkaline. Any of the salt which is present, my dear, there, it can be alkaline or it can be acidic. But the salts which we have taken, which sir you have told me, where I have written the order where it is. Okay, here it is, sir. Here order. You know these three are harmful, and all these are alkaline in nature. Okay, and all these are alkaline in nature. So I will say alkalinity will also increase. And now when you will see the option, what is the biggest problem of water logging, you will say that after water logging, my dear sir, after water logging there are many problems with the root. Many problems. My root will die. Salinity and alkalinity will be increased. Now how my farmer will reduce it? Can you engineer sitting out there, suggest me anything that how my farmer is going to solve this problem? I'm going to deal with it. Okay, salinity and alkalinity will be increased. Now what will happen? Sushma is asking for next one schedule. Yes, Sushma, don't worry. Next one schedule will be coming soon, and the subjects which are which are not finished, they will be covered first and then new subjects will be start. Simply in morning time, the batches will go in English, and in the evening time batches will run in Hindi, as you all know. Okay, so now the causes, sir. Now the causes, you all tell me what are the methods, how we can solve this problem of salinity and alkalinity. Okay, because farmer has to do it. Before that let me understand now causes of water logging. Yes, very good. Leaching. Do you understand the process of leaching? Now first let me write down causes of water logging. Causes of water logging. Now everyone comment down the causes of water logging one by one. Whatever comes in your mind, comment down below. How water logging is caused. First one is over an intensive irrigation. Your farmer goes mad and he is going on applying water. So whenever you do over irrigation, whenever he thinks more and water has to be provided, then there is a chance of your field getting waterlogged. Okay, over and intensive irrigation. Then if your water comes out from canal, okay, seepage of water from canals. You all know, my dear friend, that suppose this is your canal and it is unlined. So what will happen? Water will come out and this water will get deposited in the near field. Okay, and this area will be flooded. This is your seepage of water for canals. Acha, how will you reduce it? How will you control this cause? You will line the canal. Okay, what you will do? You will do lining of canal. When you will do lining, what will happen? Seepage will not take place and water will not reach there. Yes, understood. Very simple thing. Then what is your next cause? Simply heavy rains. Rainfall is very heavy. Then what is your next cause? Flood. Submergence due to floods. Then now suppose heavy amount of water is there, there are many channels used to drain out and remove all the water. I will say this system as drainage system. Okay, drainage system is there. Many small channels are there which are used to remove water from the field. Okay, but if your drainage system is poor, okay, I will say if these drains are in less quantity, then also your water will not be able to flow out. You all know what happens in our cities. Yes. What happens in your cities whenever rainfall is there, you see water is filled everywhere. Why? Water is locked everywhere. Why? Because your sewage system is not that proper. Okay. So I will say if improper drainage system is there, your water will log. Insufficient or improper drainage system. So we have to somehow enhance the efficiency of drainage system. If your drainage system or sewage system is enhanced, it means that as soon as your water will flood, it will be removed. As soon as your water will flood in the field, it will be removed with the help of drains. So it has to be proper. Now these are some basic causes which you all can relate. Yes, obviously you are right. Khan. If soil is less soluble, then water will be logged easily. Okay. But the basic causes. From where water comes. If your soil is less soluble and there is no rainfall, then water logging will not be there. Okay, no problem. Now, how will you control it? This is the biggest question. This is the challenge in front of a farmer. Today I will tell you each and everything. Leaching, what is leaching requirement, how my farmer performs it in actual, okay, what is drainage coefficient, I will tell you everything. Wait, and this chapter will be finished by today only. Now, the control. Now comes my control. How my water logging is controlled. Okay. Now control of water logging. Tell me how water logging will be controlled. Can you all tell me something? Simply do the reverse of the causes. Suppose your farmer was going mad and he was going on applying water and water. So tell him not to go mad and control your irrigation and use water in optimum way. Okay. Optimum use of water has to be there. Okay. Optimum use. Neither less nor more. Your water has to be used judiciously in optimum way. Okay. So, and in order to reduce the seepage of water from canals, what you can do? Lining you can do. Are you getting it? You can do lining. You can provide efficient drainage system. If insufficient and improper drainage system is there, water will be locked. Water will not run out. Okay. So, opposite of those, I will write here. First one you can write optimum use of water by my plant. Okay. I told you, if my farmer will provide sufficient water, you know, when water is increased, crop growth increases, but if water is increased beyond some limit, then crop growth goes down. I already told you. Okay, so tell your farmer to use your water in an optimum way, neither more nor less. If you provide less water with the fear of getting waterlogged, so then also crop growth will be less. And if you provide more and more water, then also water growth will be less. Okay, so use water optimum in an optimum way. Okay, next one is your reduce intensity of irrigation. Reducing intensity of irrigation. If you reduce the area in which irrigation is happening, obviously less water will be provided and your control is more. Then efficient drainage system. Yes sir, this is most important. This is the most important point because I am going to tell you drainage system today only. Efficient drainage system. If drainage system is best, then there is no problem. Within some time your all water will get cleared. Within some time all of your water will get cleared. Then okay, then there will be crop rotation. Introducing crop rotation. What happens? You should grow crops suppose water is filled, okay, in field. So in next time, suppose water has been filled in the field. So next time what you do? Next time sow the crops which require more water, okay, so that they will consume all the water. Once you can sow the crop which is consuming more water, and next time you sow the crop which is consuming less water. So in alternate fashion you can do, which will try to consume all the water which has been flooded there. Okay, what else you can think here? What else you can think? Okay, yes, lining of canal. How to reduce seepage from canal? We have to do lining. Yes, lining of canal will also reduce seepage. Seepage is reduced and water loss will also be reduced. Okay, my costly and important water, okay, is also reduced. Now this is how my farmer controls water logging. This is the way how he controls water logging. No problem. Okay, one more problem is there in front of farmer. Yes, in crop rotation, Shubham, suppose in first season there is crop which does not require much water, but still because of water logging too much water is there. So after removing that crop, in next season what you will do, you will sow the crop which requires high amount of water. So that when you are sowing the crop which is having high requirement of water, what it will do, it will consume all the water. Okay, are you clear now? Yes. Okay, now there is one bigger problem. Now there is one even bigger problem with my farmer. I told you after water logging, what is the biggest problem with that farmer? Removal of water is not a big problem. Removal of water is easy. But what happens? Salts are there. Salts remain there, okay? Your entire field is now salty. Salt concentration, alkalinity concentration. Yes, very good. Definitely from wheat to rice. It is like that. And depending on the situation, you can rotate crop. Let me tell you. Let me write down here only why crop rotation is happening and why how you do it. Okay, what is crop rotation? Crop rotation is nothing. You does not sow the same crop again and again. You does not sow the same crop again and again because if this is a field, this is a field, okay, and you grow crop A every time, you grow crop A, then what will happen? The nutrients will be finished. Nutrients in the soil will be finished because every time you are going on providing the same crop, okay? So all the nutrients of your soil will be finished, okay? So in order to replenish the nutrients which have already been exhausted, which has already been used, you will perform crop rotation. So one time you will grow crop A and next time you will grow crop B, first A and then B. So what are you doing? You are rotating the crop. Why are you rotating the crop? Okay, why are you rotating the crop? So that the nutrients which has already been consumed by A, now when B will be there, now when B crop will be there in the field, so that nutrients which has already been consumed by A will be replenished, will come again, and now the nutrients which will go away, okay, that will be your B1. So in this manner what will happen? In this manner, when you will rotate crop, your field will not be troubled, your field will not be burdened, okay, and your nutrients will get replenished, okay. So let me write down the definition here. This practice is done in order to replenish the nutrients, already consumed by the crop, so that fertility of soil is maintained. But earlier we are unaware of all these things. What we did, we used to grow one crop again and again. Now what happened? All the nutrients are reduced, all the nutrients are finished. So what will happen? Your land will go barren and there will be problem. So what early man used to do, okay, you all must be familiar with Homo sapiens early man, okay. What they used to do, they used to wander. They go at one place, they grow the crops, and when your field is useless, they only grow same crop again and again. When your field is useless, they wander. They remove that field, okay, they isolate that field and they move on to the next field. Again, they do the same practice and they move on, okay. But now what happens? Now we are aware of the fact, so what we now do? We rotate the crop so that nutrients are remaining there. So that water requirement is balanced. If someone is requiring high water, next one will require less water. So in this balance will be maintained. In this way, balance will be maintained. Okay. Now the biggest problem with my farmer, dear sir, is that your land is full of salt. After your water has evaporated, sir, white patches, salts are there. And if salts are there, my farmer will be in problem because seeds are expensive. He will sow the seeds, okay, he will sow the seeds, seeds are expensive and it will die, because you all know, whenever my dear sir in the field salts are there, all the water will come out, all the water from the roots will come out, okay, so there is a big problem, of salinity and alkalinity. There is a big problem after waterlogging, okay, there is a big problem because entire field is flooded with salts now. Salts are remaining there, even though land is dry, but still white patches salts are there, okay, which is very injurious to my plant. Now what my farmer can do, I am going to tell you, leaching is there, okay, let me listen very carefully, let me write down the heading, reclamation of saline and alkaline soil. What does it mean? It means soil which has already been destroyed, with the salts, whiteboard you are saying. Okay dear friend, I will try. Today bear with it. Listen, what I am saying here. So I was telling you that your field, okay, now is full of salt. Your field has gone, and you have to reclaim that field. Okay. Recovery of salty land. Recovery of salty and alkaline land is known as reclamation. Reclamation means that your land has to be recovered so that again crops can be grown. Recovery of salty and alkaline land is known as reclamation of field. Achha, now what will my farmer do? I am going to tell you. Okay. There is a process. This is the biggest problem. Removal of water is not a big problem. If water is staying there, if water is locked there, simply with passage of time, water will evaporate. Water will go in drains, and removal of water is not a big problem. But after waterlogging, what is the biggest problem? Salts are remaining there, which will prove very fatal to my crop. So what my farmer does, he performs leaching. Let me write down the heading. He will perform leaching. Okay. Sir, what is leaching? Remember this term very carefully, because this is only important from GATE point of view. Rest all was concept. Okay. Now someone is saying write on whiteboard, someone is saying write on white blackboard. I think black color is fine. Okay. Sooner or later you will be able to adjust with it, okay, no problem. Okay, so I was telling you, what is leaching now? Now what happens when your this is your field, this is filled with salt. Now what will happen after your water has gone? Your farmer will come here, okay, and he will flood the entire field with water. He will put too much of water here. Okay, why he is doing so? Now what he will do? He will come here and he will mix the crop. He will mix the entire soil with water. Okay, this farmer will start mixing. So what happens after mixing this water with soil? Mixing of soil and water starts, and this is done by your farmer. Okay. And this water you have provided. This water is your irrigation water. This was your irrigation water. Some water is now utilized for salt. Now soil and water has been started mixing by your farmer. He will agitate the field. He will keep on churning and mixing the soil. what will happen with the help of this mixing process, all the soluble salts which are deposited there, okay, listen very carefully, what will happen? They will mix with water. Okay, they will come in water. Okay, I will say they will. Okay, now there is one water in which all the soluble salts is there. Okay, so now your soluble salts have mixed with water. Now this water is very harmful because it is containing all the salts. And we will drain out this water. We will drain out this water which will remove all the salts. Suppose, my dear friend, what happens? Now you know that a farmer has applied water. If this water, which is containing high amount of salt, will leach down automatically, because now water table has gone below. Because water logging has already occurred. Now water is not there. Now this water, which is containing, this is the water which is containing soluble salts, will leach down and join groundwater again, and join the groundwater table again, which is very much below, and groundwater will now again contain the salts. Okay, you all know that salts came only from your groundwater. Excuse me. So I was saying that groundwater was containing salts, and after this leaching, this water which has been provided by a farmer, he has mixed all the salts in it, and this deadly water, this concentrated water will leach down to the soil and join the groundwater table again, and all the salts will again reach the ground, and again it will again reach the ground. Or there is one more option, that from the drainage system he can remove this water. So he has two options. Firstly, he can wait for leaching down of this water. And next is he can remove this water with the help of drains. Nalia we call it as. Okay, with the help of drain he can remove this water. So let me write down what is leaching. Acha, listen now. After this process, all your salt is gone. Farmer is happy now. With the help of some water, he has applied some water extra for dissolving the salts and then removing that water. Now he is happy. Now there are no salts there. He is happy now. After that, what he will do? After these salts are removed, first he will grow the crops which are high salt tolerant. After your salt is removed, first, he will not directly sow the crops which are normal. He will sow the crop which are having high tolerance. Okay. After this process, he will sow the crop which are having high salt resistant, which are having high resistance towards salt, which are high salt resistant crops. Okay. Why? Because he is not going to take risk. He will sow the crops which are having high salt resistance, which are having high tolerance towards salt. Okay. Then after that crop, your field has been completely reclaimed, and now there is no problem of salinity alkalinity, and your field is fully okay. Okay, so after this leaching, your entire process will be, there will be no problem. So let me write down the definition. It is simply, in one line, your entire land is flooded with sufficient depth of water. Okay, why this water is provided? In order to mix all the soluble salts. Land is flooded with sufficient depth of water. Okay, sufficient depth of water in order to dissolve all the soluble salts. Okay, in order to dissolve all the soluble salts okay, comma, the water which is containing these soluble salts, the water containing these soluble salts is drained out through drainage system which is there in the field. Okay, there are many paths, there are many channels, there are ditches through drainage system, or I told you through drainage system, or this water can join your groundwater table with the help of leaching, or this water can leach down and join groundwater table again, and your salt will again reach from where it has started and join groundwater table again. Okay, so this is your leaching. No problem, sir. Simply I am clear with this. Now after leaching, my dear sir, he will grow first high salt tolerant crop. Let me write down here. After leaching, okay, high salt tolerant crop is grown. Acha, which is your high salt tolerant crop? Let me write down some example. For example, bajra is there, barseem is there, okay, fodder is there. All these are high salt resistant crop. If you grow fodder in such areas, no problem will be there. Fodder will grow in a normal fashion. Okay, are grown after leaching. These high salt resistant crop are grown, after which your land is said to be fully reclaimed. Okay, after which your land is fully reclaimed and now you will say there is no problem of salinity neither alkalinity, because when salts are there, salinity and alkalinity problem is there. Questions which are asked in exam sometimes. Now Sajan is saying, sir, BMC, okay, he is checking out BMC videos. Okay, thank you Sajan, long message. It boosts our confidence and keeps us going on. Thank you, Sajan. I will try my best. Yes, BMC videos are being highly praised by my students, I know. Everything is for you all, no problem. Okay, so let's move ahead. So let me write down one thing. See, this question can be asked in exam, so I am just telling you. Sometimes what happens, in order to remove these salts, we add neutralizer. What this neutralizer do? This neutralizer is added to your field and it neutralizes the salt which is already present there. Okay, no problem. Yes. So what are the example of neutralizer that we use? See, your soil can be of two types. Either it can be alkaline soil or it can be acidic, and it depends totally on the salt solution. Suppose salt solution is there, its pH can be greater than 7 and its pH can be less than 7 also. Okay, it can be equal to 7 also, then your soil will be neutral, then there will be no problem. Okay, there is third type of soil also, neutral soil. Okay, simply in this pH will be 7 when you will form solution of your salts. Okay, so now problem is with the first two. Third one is okay, in third there is no problem, but in the first two, these are extreme cases. So what we can do, what is the remedy which we can provide, sir? What is the remedy? That is, now you add gypsum in alkaline soil. You add gypsum, okay, you are going to add gypsum because gypsum is somewhat acidic. Formula you all know, CaSO4 dot 2H2O, or simply we can write CaSO4. This have a neutralizing effect. Let me write down neutralizing effect. Okay, this gypsum will react with your alkaline soil, alkaline salt which is already there, and it will neutralize it. Okay, gypsum will neutralize the salts. So you can add gypsum which comes out in your bag. You will apply gypsum. Okay, now in acidic soil, opposite of acid is lime. Limestone is somewhat alkaline. Okay, limestone formula you know, CaCFe or CaO. This will also have what this limestone will do, it will also neutralize. It will find yourself neutralize the salt. It will also neutralize the salt. I hope it is clear. Yes, very much clear. Simple thing. Yes, sir. No problem. Yes, Badra is there. I already told you. Yes, sir. Now I am fully clear with the leaching topic. Now leaching is fully clear to me. Now you all know that in this process of leaching, some water is required. Some water is required, my dear friend. Okay. That water is known as leaching requirement. Let me write down here. Okay, now let me write down what is leaching requirement. The water which is required to dissolve all the salt, okay, the water which is required to dissolve all the salt is your leaching requirement, denoted by LR. Okay, I told you that except consumptive, okay, excluding consumptive, the water which is required by crops, some water is required in leaching which is there to dissolve all the salts. Okay, that is nothing but your leaching requirement, and free soil requirement is also there. Yes, Sushma, he will apply leaching. There is no need to remove all the dead plants. He will apply leaching as soon as he feels that your land is salty. As soon as he sees that your land is salty, he will remove all the things and he will try to dissolve all the salts and he will leach it down. Okay. Whenever salt problem is there, leaching is done not only after removing dead plants. Leaching is done as soon as my farmer visualizes that salts are being deposited there, heavy salt are being deposited there, he will try to remove it as soon as possible. Okay. So these are all your irrigation requirements. Now I think you are clear with what is leaching requirement. Let me write down here. Okay, the amount of water which is used in leaching process is your leaching requirement, my dear friends. Okay, now listen very carefully. You all can understand that. Listen here. The depth of irrigation water which you provide, listen very carefully. The depth of irrigation water that you provide has to be divided into two parts. One part is your consumptive use, and next part is your leaching requirement water. I will say this is, sir, your total depth of water which you are providing in the field. Total depth of irrigation water which you are providing in the field. Some part will be used for the growth of crop. I will say consumptive use. Okay, this depth of water CU is used by a crop. And this water is your leaching water. Depth of drained water. Why I am writing drained water? Because drained water will contain salts. salts. Okay. My dear sir, drain water will contain all the soluble salts which are there. Okay, that water which is carrying all the salts with it, that is your drained water, depth of drained water. So now I have understood, sir. Now I have understood that besides irrigation, besides your consumptive use, there is one more use which is your leaching. Okay, so this water is used in your leaching process. Let me write down. This water has been used in leaching process. Yes. Used in leaching process. Yes. So now suppose you are providing 10 cm of water, 6 cm your plant takes, and 4 cm is used in leaching. 4 cm used in leaching. Okay. So you have one ratio. Leaching requirement, leaching ratio is ratio of depth of drained water upon depth of irrigation water. Depth of drained water, because this water is only used in your leaching. Acha, now tell me, what is depth of drained water? It is nothing but total water which is you are provided up minus consumptive use. Are you can see from here na, PD is nothing but DI minus CU upon DI. So this will come out as 1 minus CU upon DI, which will come out as CU 1 minus CU upon DI. In exam, leaching ratio can be calculated. In exam, leaching ratio can be asked. Okay, and it is very simple. You all can simply solve. I have told you this formula so that you all remember it. Suppose in this example only, you have provided 10 cm water, 6 has been used by your crop in its growth, and 4 cm has been used by your farmer to remove the salts. So what is your leaching requirement here in this question? Simply, you can write depth of drained water is 4, depth of drained water is 4, and depth of irrigation water is 10. Depth of irrigation water is 10. What it does mean? It means 0.4. It means out of total water, listen very carefully. It means out of total water, 40% or 0.4 times of total water, this water is required for leaching. Okay, 40% or 0.4 times of total water is used for leaching, which will solubilize all the salts, okay, which will carry all the dissolved salt with it. So this is your nothing but your leaching requirement. Okay, now the last topic after which this chapter will be finished is your drainage system. Very simple it is. You all know, I told you today only that this water will leach down and join the groundwater table. I told you, no problem. But it can also leave with the help of drains. This water which is having high amount of salts can also leave with the help of drains. Okay. So there are many types of drainage which are provided. You can understand. Okay, there are many types of drainage which are provided. So let me write down one heading which is very simple. There is no problem as such. Okay. Drainage system and its type. It is very simple. It will hardly take 5 minutes and you will understand everything. It is very simple. Drainage system and types of drainage system. Okay. Drainage system and then your types of drainage system. You only need the names of types of drain. That much is sufficient. Because in GATE exam, nothing much is asked. But since we are covering ESE aspect also, so I am trying to cover all the theory as well. Okay. ESE, from ESE point of view. Okay. In GATE, you all know water logging chapter is not important. I already told you in the first class. So what is your drainage system? The network of ditches or channels which assist in removing extra water from field, which assist in removing extra water from field or whatever water which is not utilized. Okay, whatever water which is not utilized. Now, my dear friends, I hope this is simple, very simple. Now, drainage are of two types, my dear friend. Drainage are of two types. It can be surface drainage. You can see your ditches, drains, channels on your surface, above the surface, on the surface, you can see it. So drainage are of two types. One is your surface drainage, my dear friend, and the next one is your subsurface drainage. Next one is your subsurface drainage. Okay, my dear friends. First one is your surface drainage and next one is your subsurface drainage. So in surface drainage, let me write down one line here. These drains are located above the soil. These drains are provided above the surface. Okay, above the soil. These drains are provided above surface. And obviously, subsurface will be provided. These drains will be provided below the soil. These drains are provided below surface. Okay. Now the examples, because examples can be asked. Okay, examples can be asked. Acha, when very common type of surface drainage is your, when very common type of your surface drainage is open drainage, my dear friends. Let me write down here. When very common type of your surface drainage is your open drainage system. In this open drainage system, you all know, it's very simple. First, let me write down point by point. Let me write down with different ink. First one is your open drainage system. Okay. Different type of system is there. This you should not focus. You must not focus on all these types. Okay. And its design, you all know, drainage design is also there. That you don't have to focus. Then your surface inlet are there. Then your French inlet are there. These are different types of inlet. These are different types of drain which are provided in order to drain out all the water. Okay. This you must not focus much. Then there is your bedding. Okay. These four are very common type of surface drainages which are used in India. These four all are very common type of drainages which are used in India. Acha, what is your open drainage system? Open drainage system is see here. Suppose your water is coming with the help of this channel. From this channel, it will go into this channel. From this channel, it will go into this channel. And finally, it will collect here. And finally, all the water will collect here. And from here, it will be removed. So, since your water in the field is flowing in open channels, okay, it's flowing in open way and it is exposed to the surface, water will flow from here, okay, ditches are made. Suppose this is your field and water is from here, water is going here, then it is going here and from this area it is leaving the field, and from this area it is leaving the field and outside somewhere your water has been stored. Okay, so this is nothing but your open drainage, simply connection of surface drainages one by one. Okay, sir, simple. It is simple, nothing big, nothing tough in this. Okay, nothing tough. So this is also your open drainage system. Many drains are interlinked and that too exposed on the surface, and water flows under gravity from high level to low level. What is your surface inlet? Sir, in surface inlet, what happens? There is an inlet provided. Like you have sewer in your house, na? You must have openings in your washrooms. There are small openings provided. Okay. This is covered. Okay. So what happens? Water flows down and enters this inlet and reaches the, this is surface inlet, because from this inlet, water goes inside and there is a network here. From here, water goes out. So this small opening is known as your surface inlet. Okay, no problem. Yes, sir, clear. Okay, similar is your French drain. In French drain, you excavate some soil. Okay, suppose this is your field. You excavate soil from here. You remove soil from here. Now what you do? You lay down pipes. Okay. These pipes are for removing extra water. You lay them pipes, and then you again fill the soil with water, and then you again fill the soil, and then you again fill the soil, backfill it. Okay. Now what will happen whenever water will come? Whenever water will be there, that water will automatically flow in this French drain. It is porous. Okay. These drains are porous, and from this French drain water will move, and from this French drain water will move. Okay. It is simple. Yes, clear. Okay, clear till here. And what is a bedding? Bedding is nothing. I told you furrows. You all remember furrow irrigation. This was your furrow irrigation. I already told you. This was a furrow irrigation. Which ridge and furrow, ridge and furrow, ridge and furrow were there? In furrow, we used to carry water. Remember? In furrow, we used to carry water. And this was your higher point. This was a ridge. Now this ridge is called as bed. This is your bed. And these furrows are now dead. Okay. These are not used for carrying water in order to supply water to your crops. Now these furrows are dead. What dead means? Dead means now these are not required in field. These are only remaining there. These are not required for providing water to your crops. Okay, now they are not in use. So I will say these furrows are dead now. Not in use. These furrows or small fallow channels are dead. And now why this will be used? Now since they are not used for supplying water, they will be used for removing water. Earlier they were used for supplying water. Now they will be used for removing water. So what is your dead furrows? I will write here. The furrows which are not in use now are known as bedding. Okay. So I will say dead furrows which are not in use are used for removing water. Dead furrows are used for removing water. Okay. And all these are above surface, are used for removing excess water or your drainage water. So these all are your surface drainage, and the most popular in subsurface drainage. And my dear friends, most popular in subsurface drainage is your tile drainage system. Wait, let me write down. With there is only one which is very important, that is your tile drainage system. Okay. These tile drains you have to provide below the surface. These tile drains, my dear friend, you have to provide below the surface. How it is provided? It is very simple, sir. How it is provided? Let me show you. It is very simple. Suppose this is your ground, my dear friend. This is your ground. Okay. Suppose this is your water table. Let us suppose that this is your initial water table. And suppose this is your hard rock stratum. This is your impervious rock below which water cannot go. Let me write down here. This is your impervious stratum. Okay. Okay, my dear friends. Yes. This is your surface. And This is your water table. We draw a water table like this. Yes. Yes, sir. Yes, clear. This is your water table. Okay. And let me show water table by this symbol. Surface is shown by this symbol and water table is shown by this symbol. You all know there will be plants. Yes, sir. Plants will be there. Definitely. Okay. Plants are there. Roots are there. Roots will be there. But sir, listen very carefully. No matter what, my roots should not come in contact with groundwater. Otherwise, what will happen? I already told you, capillary effect will start, my dear friends, and all the water will start coming out to the surface. As I told you, suctional process. As I told you beforehand, the suction process. Okay. Any problem? No problem, sir, here till. Okay? So, sir, this is your initial groundwater table. This is your initial groundwater table. I will write down here, initial groundwater table. Okay, before drainage, no drainage has started till now. But now, since you want to lower it further, you will provide tile drains. You will provide, my dear friend, tile drains. Tile drains are provided below the surface. So this will be your tile drain. See, you have provided tile drains. This is are your tile drains. You will provide tile drains again with certain spacing. You will provide tile drains again. What will happen again? Now what will happen? This groundwater which is here, water will start coming down. Water will start coming down till it will reach your tiles. Okay, till it will reach your tiles. This water starts coming out and flowing, starts flowing in tiles. Okay. If you see cross section of tile, you will see this is your tile. Water is coming in this tile like this. Water is coming in tile like this, and it is flowing inside tile, which is circular in nature, and it is leaving out the field. After some area, this is leaving out. Okay, no problem till here. Yes, sir. Clear? No problem. Okay. So this is the thing. Now how water comes out? Listen. What happens? Water will start decreasing in this manner. Because water is flooded, and obviously it will come down. Obviously it should start coming down. It will come down like this. See, now your water level has come down. Okay, why this type of flow lines are there? Because water is flowing towards the tile drain. Okay, water is flowing towards the tile drain. That's why now water table will look like this. Okay, now after some time water table will be like this. Your water table is coming again down, and finally it will reach like this, and finally the shape of your water table will be like this. Okay, and it will not go beyond this, because all the water will now have been removed by tiles, and obviously now water has reached your tiles, and water will not go beyond this. Water will not go below the tiles. Okay, simple. Yes sir, it is simple. Okay, now what is the formula for tiles? This is your A. Listen very carefully. This is your A. What is A? A is the distance of center of tiles and impervious drainage. A is the distance between center of tiles and your impervious layer. What is B? B is your distance from impervious strata to highest point on water table. See here. This is the highest point, highest point, and impervious strata is B, and from center to impervious strata is your A. Okay. Let me write down. This is your final water level. Okay. This is your final groundwater table level. Groundwater level after complete drainage. After entire water has drained down into your tiles. No problem. Yes, sir. Clear? Now what is the formula for spacing? You all know. Let me write down here. The center to center spacing of tile drain is known as S. Okay, S is nothing but your spacing of tile drain. So the formula for S is nothing but 4K upon Q. You simply have to remember this. There is no need to derive this. Okay, I can derive this, but there is no need. This topic is not that important. Okay, simply mug up this formula if you want. This is your spacing of tile drains. Okay. S is nothing but spacing. You can see spacing here. You know na, when your farmer is providing tiles in your field, he wants to know that how much far, what should be the spacing between tiles, he should know. Okay. So in order to find the spacing, you can use this formula. Let me write down S is nothing but spacing of tile drains. What is Q? From where square is? Square is not here, my dear friend. Let me remove square. Square is not here. What is your Q? Q is nothing but discharge per unit width. Okay, you must be familiar with discharge per unit width. That is your Q. Okay. What is K? K is permeability. K is permeability. K is permeability. You all know. What is B? B, I told you, distance between, distance between impervious strata and highest point of groundwater table, and that to final groundwater table. This is your final level, C. This is your final level, and this was your initial level. Water has started draining. Water has started draining and coming down, and this is your final level. Okay. Yes, sir. This is B. And what is your A? Distance between impervious strata and center of your, my dear friend, center of your drain. Okay. So this is your trial drains which are provided below the surface. These are trial drains which are provided below the surface. Okay. Whose spacing you can find with the help of this formula. And beneath the ground, they are provided beneath the ground, somewhat 1 to 1.5 meters below the ground, so that my water is continuously removed. Okay. Water enters in this radially from all sides. Okay. And then water is carried out longitudinally in this tile, which is removed further from this, water is removed. Okay. So this is your tile drains. This is porous in nature. This is 1 to 1.5 below, and you have provided tile drains only. Okay, you have provided tile drains only because so that your roots, no matter what, your roots should never touch your groundwater. Roots should never touch your groundwater. Otherwise, a suction will start, a suction pressure will start, and entire water will be sucked by your roots, and it will reach your surface. It will reach your surface, as I have told you in this phenomenon. Okay, as I have told you here. See, I have told you here that capillary water will be continuously sucked by your roots, and it will come out and deposit on the surface. And then what problems will be caused? Then what problems are caused? You all know, salinity, alkalinity, everything will be increased, as I told you today. So this is the end of your water logging, my dear friends. This is the end of water logging. You know the salts, you know the alkalinity, you know what are the ill effects, you know the causes of, you know the control. If salts are there, then also you know how to control. You know what is efflorescence. Now you also know what is leaching. Okay, you know everything. You are now in full control. You know leaching requirement. You know all types of drainage system. You are fully aware of tile drainage. So this is it. This is it. And these are, let me write down the heading here. And now you are fully aware of water logging concept. Okay, and now you are able to design also tile drainage. Okay, with the help of this formula. So now let's finish our class. See you all tomorrow, guys. I hope everything is clear. There is no problem now. You all can follow me on all these links. That is very important from GATE point of view. Yes, Aniket, YouTube lecture PDF you will get on Telegram channel. Don't worry. Let some things finished. Let some topics get finished, and I will club all these PDFs into one, because that will be much more easier. If you will get lecture wise PDF, that will be very difficult for you, because each and every lecture, your phone will get heavy, na? Your phone is not getting that much of storage, students are telling me, so I am trying to convert entire into one PDF, okay? So that less PDFs are there. Okay, take care. See you all tomorrow with canal design.